Hey guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to Adam's Quest. In the last episode, Rameme met the blind wanderer on the very edge of the savannah, and he wasn't in our tribe for very long, but he captured the hearts of so many of our tribe mates. So it was only natural that their very next baby would be named in his honor. We have Ronuta II, who is going to be quite important to the future of our tribe too. He has that perfect mix of the stripes and the poison fangs as well, so he is quite connected to Adam's old family, and I think Rameme is probably going to realize that. She was given the bluebird feathers from her father when he saw those lovely stripes that she's wearing, so I think she's probably going to try to train him up so he's ready to lead the tribe someday too. They have quite a bit in store for them after all, especially because we have Truffle and Needle making their way dangerously close to that strange jungle biome off in the north. It seems like today we're going to find out once and for all if we have any apes to deal with on this island. Right now we only have tons and tons of bunnies hopping right around that swampland, so it's a much less menacing smell that they're picking up right now, but they're still being very cautious. Needle has seen the visions after all from the god of sacrifice himself, so she's still not sure if they're even going to make it back from this mission. Rameme does have a brand new promise to take care of though. When Ronuta I heard that she was trying to find her father's lost family, he thought that maybe she could help him out too. We figure he must have been traveling with somebody in this giant savannah that we have completely covered in darkness, so she's going to see if she can find anybody else who might have known Ronuta before he passed away. Before we get them moving though, we do have to take a quick trip over to our hunters, because they, as always, have tons of bunnies to scoop up. So Vanta is the dedicated bunny spotter. He sits right on that stump to let Tara know where she needs to go to gather up the most food. It looks like we actually have a little mole here too. And maybe Emma could actually help them out with that. She's making her way up toward the jungle too, though mostly because of Kuvan's wishes, the one who taught her how to crack open acorns. He has a love for many different types of food, and she seems to share that same sort of mindset, so she's hoping that there might be some exotic food to sample way up in the north. But if we could maybe make the mole turn a little bit further, maybe Vanta could go ahead and pick up some of this grass a little bit more, because now it's really looking at her. Good thing she didn't actually try to lunge at it then, because it would have turned right in her direction. Now she should be able to sneak her way over here and grab it from behind and then pick up that mole meat too. So I think that might actually be her first taste of mole meat. Maybe even her first taste of meat in general. So she's slowly but surely sampling all of the food that she can possibly find in this island. I think she might actually like to stay with the hunters for a little while just to learn their ways, because they do have a very unique way of gathering their food. Now Kuvan, on your very last day, why don't you go ahead and gather up as many acorns as you possibly can? We could even bring you over here to gather up your soggy acorns too. Those are probably a little bit easier for him to eat right now. That means that our initial ports, of course, are all going to go dark because he was the very last creature sitting under this initial tree that we landed by. But it's all for good reason, because we are going to start making our way to the north to hopefully get to that new island. Oh my goodness, so you guys have a bunny back here. Wait a second. Truffle, you definitely want to scoop that up because you don't know what's waiting out there, so you might need the extra food. It looks like quite a few of the bunnies have hopped away, so why don't we take this as our moment to move a bit deeper, a bit closer to the jungle itself. Truffle can jump right over here, which is on the border of the swamp, but those bunnies, it makes me wonder if they're scared of something. Maybe there is actually something way off in the swamplands that we need to be made aware of, because they all seem to be trying to run away from it right now into the waiting jaws of our creatures. We're super, super close to that tree though, so if anything is going to spawn, I would imagine it's going to be very, very soon, as soon as those apes get a whiff of our creatures. But over here, everyone is safe and sound. We have Pine, of course, spending time with her very good friend Issa. They are the greatest hunters that this tribe has ever seen, and they're doing their best to clear out this land too, so that we can at least pick up some more of those bunnies. This was where Ronuta found the bunny burrow. Even though he was blind, he was very good at tracking them down. But I thought maybe they could do a little bit of training too. We do have these normal berry bushes over here, and since they're not quite strong enough to fully attack the bush, so they can't really take it out in one swipe, we could actually use this for training. We know that the normal berry bushes will grow back, so even if they do manage to swipe it up in one hit, then we'll still get the extra food, we'll get the extra nesting material, and we know that in a few days, we'll see all of those berries back on that bush again. So Issa, if you could go ahead and attack it a few times too, there we go, so she was a little bit stronger. She managed to take out the berry bush completely, but that will give us more actions toward getting the ram horns and the claw too. So it's all for a good cause, and it's certainly helping to prove themselves in the eyes of Rameme. Now she wouldn't want to get too far away from her precious son, of course, so let's bring her over here to pick up some of the berries. And then I suppose Button is probably going to try to find some more poison berries to eat. Rokirnu is taking care of this berry bush after all, so he needs to find a new one now. I'd imagine the savanna is probably not the best place for him to find poison berries, but he can still come over here to clear out some grass, because he knows that his mate is going to be traveling there in the future. So he can hitch a ride too on this tiny little bridge, and we'll see if he can find anything to eat in the lush portions of the island. Now we're just down to Toadstool, which is quite fitting because I think he's getting a little bit tired of constantly being left behind. So I suppose we could bring him way back here to join his friend Pine again. He hasn't seen her in quite a while, and he could definitely help out by clearing out all of this grass, and maybe even by picking up some acorns too. We do have this lovely tree way over here as well, so since he has the nimble fingers, he would be perfect for that job. But let's zoom out and skip the day and keep a very, very close eye on the north to make sure that our jungle explorers are safe, of course. I think they might be. So far, it looks like they can't hear or smell anything, so they might be okay. In fact, the only thing I did hear were bunnies spawning on their burrows. Yeah, we have one way over here where Ronuta found them before. So Issa, why don't you jump over to this side to grab up this bunny for us? They've almost successfully cleared out this entire area too, so they are really doing well on their mission. Now, as far as this baby goes, I was actually thinking about giving him the orange gems, just like Ronuta the first, of course, but also because it would yet again connect him to Adam's family, since Adam is so well known for having that orange fur. So we'll give him the orange gems for now, and then I suppose you two can start making your way toward that savanna after all. We'll have Rameme gather up some very last berries, then the baby can scoot his way out of the nest so he's next to his father, which will keep him safe, but Rameme can spend her time clearing out that bridge. I feel like we might also want to breed them again one last time just in case. Just in case there's any more wanderers out in the grass so Rameme won't have to worry. She can focus on her mission instead. Now I was going to have Rokirnu pick his berries, but it looks like the bunnies are being a nuisance yet again. So Truffle, go ahead and grab this one for us. I really think that the bunnies are just getting a little bit scared by something in the grass. This is quite worrying that they're all running straight toward us. We had one over here though, so where did it go, Vanta? I'm not sure if Terra is going to be able to reach it because it is pretty deep into the grass, so maybe that's a good sign that we should clear out a little bit more so they can move around a bit easier, and that'll also make the bunnies think that we're not paying attention to them apparently. And then now might be a good time to have Amma maybe investigate these berry bushes that we can smell off in the grass. Since Vanta has a different duty to perform, and since it looks like those bunnies are actually stealing our berries, and not only that, but one of them is a poison berry bush, so you can go ahead and pick up one of your very favorite snacks, maybe share them with your new friends if they're feeling particularly adventurous. I guess we'll use Vanta's very last turn on this acorn just to see if it's possible to pick up, but unfortunately he wasn't able to crack that open. So we can go back here instead and make sure that Rokirnu is picking up all of his berries too. I think he'll probably go with his parents. I don't think he wants to get left behind, so we'll make sure that he tags along. We'll bring Button over here to pick up the very last of the grass in the area as well, and then it's just up to you guys yet again. We have a berry bush over here that maybe Truffle could help collect from, but then it's time to cross your way into the swamp. And already we're seeing the very first poison berries of the swamplands too. Unfortunately, that's not going to help you guys out too much. I don't think you're going to want to sample that food for yourselves, but it's good to know because maybe Amma will be able to pick that up when she gets up here. Yeah, so far I'm not seeing anything different, but we are super, super close to that tree. The only thing blocking us are actually these thorns, and we don't want to get too close to those. We can actually attack them to get them out of our path, but it will hurt our creatures quite a bit, so that's going to be kind of like a last resort. Instead, let's make sure that we're clearing out the grass behind us in case we do need to escape. And then I guess we're ready to skip the day and just watch super close to our creatures in the north. Yeah, let's zoom in here. Let's make sure that we don't have any apes popping out of that grass. So far, so good yet again, so maybe we are safe after all. Maybe this is a little safe haven where they can start their own stealthy families. Needle, of course, is quite glad to have the company after all. She didn't really want to tell him because it's not the best of things. Oh my goodness, and how perfect is this? We stumbled our way straight into one of the permanent nests? Well, I think it's pretty clear that Needle would take this as some sort of sign. Some sort of sign from Comet himself, maybe, that this is their tiny little sanctuary right next to the jungle biome, where they can start their families. Since they both have the black fur in their genetics, there is a possibility that their babies could be super stealthy in the jungle anyway, and we do want to keep those dots too because those also help in the jungle biomes. So why don't we go ahead and alter their mutation menus a little bit? Needle did have the short-sighted eyes trait, so we want to make sure that she has the normal eyes in one of her slots, and then I think the dots in the other one. We definitely want to see more spotty little mushroom babies if possible. Then we could have Truffle breed with her, so she can settle herself down right inside this nest and hopefully pick up a little bit of the grass too. I mean, I'm sure she's still a little bit concerned, a little bit worried seeing that giant jungle tree looming above them, so hopefully this isn't some sort of trap trying to get them to let their guard down. I mean, I don't think it's even crossed her mind that this nest might have been abandoned for a reason. So close to the tree, so close to the swamp, and so close to so many things that could potentially harm their babies. I guess that's why Rameme is being a little bit more cautious. She's leading her family very slowly into the unknown grasslands. So let's have her scoot up this way, and then maybe she could actually play leapfrog with Ronuta. It looks like he moves a little bit slower, so that might be difficult. It's probably because of those nimble fingers, but he can still do his best. Oh, and Rokirnu is all grown up now too. He is actually dwarfing his father. Button must be feeling a very awkward right now, with his son looming over him too. Let's have Rokirnu pick up those very last berries then he can follow his mother into the grass. And Button, of course, is not going to want to be very far behind. He can go way in front of their youngest son, and then sniff around a little bit to make sure they're not walking into any danger. Yeah, I don't see any creatures out in the grass just yet, but that doesn't mean that nobody is living here. And then Issa and Pine can get back to their training. So do we only have this poison berry bush left? Let's see, I think that might be the case. We do have a shriveled up one over here, but maybe Toadstool would prefer to pick the berries. I think he misses the sweet taste of his normal berries. He will enjoy the acorns, of course, but the berries are always going to be his very favorite snack. So since nobody over here can even use the poison berry bush right now, I think it'll be okay if we, oh, we can't actually attack it. Okay, so we do need the higher attack strength to even attempt to take down the toxic berry bush. So no more training for you, Issa, but you've proven yourself anyway. Instead, we'll have them come over here to make sure that Toadstool is safe. They're kind of like his little guardians, I guess. His very strong warrior friends. Now it should just be down to the hunters though. So do you guys have any more of those pesky bunnies to scoop up in the grass? It looks like quite a few of them have moved toward the swamplands, except for this one who is feasting on all of the food that we've left behind. So we do want to keep moving north. I think that means that Terra is going to have to abandon her chances of getting that tiny bunny by Kuvan's tree. Even Vanta might need to get down from his stump to clear out a little bit of the grass around here. And there is yet another one of those bunnies, so pick that one up. And this one too, three bunnies in a row? What on earth, Vanta? You just found bunny paradise over here. He's so tired from snatching up all of those bunnies that he can't even grab the very last one. Are there any more in the grass? No, that's the last one out of all of the bunnies that were hopping around that jungle. Oh my goodness. So at least you guys are going to be having a feast on the next turn. And not only that, but he's close enough now that he could probably smell the some healing fruit off in the distance. He does have the big nose, so he's a little bit more sensitive to interesting smells. So maybe he would let the other creatures know that there's something they need to investigate. Of course, Truffle and Needle already found it themselves, but they didn't stick around because they had a different mission to take care of. And now, of course, we have the birth of our very first potential jungle baby. Let's hope that this isn't going to be a mistake after all. I don't see any danger yet, so we might actually be okay. Maybe this truly is a little sanctuary in the jungle. And their baby, thankfully, I think has both of the traits that we were looking for, the black fur and the spots. That is quite interesting. It almost looks like maybe mud? Maybe mud of the swamps or the jungle rubbed onto her fur? Oh, that's so cool. I bet she was really touched by Takir then, because of course he loved to play in the mud too. So she's going to blend in super, super well with the jungles if we ever come across another one of those jungle biomes anyway on the future islands. I think we'll name her Dusk. I would like to give them dark, quiet, maybe stealthy sort of names, because it seems like that would be perfect for their line. And of course, she has those rosy ram horns and spikes too, almost like the pink color that you might find in the sky at sunset. So I think we will have them extend their little jungle family, but I wonder if there's a different snout in the mutation menu that might be a little bit more useful than the derp snout. Oh, we actually have the cracker jaw now, excellent. That one might be interesting. I mean, there's not much that they can crack open in the jungle itself. I don't think we're going to want to pick up too many of the nuts that fall under this tree, because that might actually spawn the ape. So maybe not the cracker jaw. But we could do the big nose. That would be particularly helpful in the jungle because they're spending so much time trying to sniff around for dangers. So let's scoot Needle over here. She wouldn't want to get too far away from this lovely safe haven, of course. And then we'll have Truffle go ahead and breed with her so she can place down one of her nests. We'll have to make sure that we're clearing out this grass too, because they're going to end up getting lost at this rate, or completely separated from the rest of the tribe, so nobody else will be able to find their tiny little sanctuary. And speaking of which, we have so much bunny meat to collect. Tara, come on over here and help out Vanta. Oh my goodness, yet another bunny. You guys are never going to go hungry again at this rate. Well, thankfully, Vanta had just enough energy to pick up all of that bunny meat, and then he can still come over here to possibly investigate not only the mole, but also this healing fruit. So this might be a good opportunity for Amma to sample yet another very, very exotic flavor. She actually took a little bit of damage. I want to say that she was picking a leech off of one of our spiky-bodied creatures, and that caused her to take one day's worth of damage, which in all honesty is not very much. It's not quite enough to even humor the thought of wasting it on a healing fruit. But since we're so safe at the moment, since we haven't even run into our very first carnivore yet, I think we might allow Amma to experiment with the healing fruit. It might call out to her adventurous nature as well, because at the moment our creatures don't know what this is, so she would be the one brave enough willing to try it out to see if maybe it's poisonous so nobody else gets hurt in the process. Now you guys back here, nobody has any leeches, right? That's always the major concern when we have creatures sitting next to the water. So Pine, you might want to scoot on up here to clear out the grass a little bit closer to the mainland. We could also have them swim around a bit too. We still don't really have a way to pick up the fish because we don't have those claws, but the more that we attack them, the more likely we are to unlock that in the mutation menu. So maybe Issa wants an even bigger challenge. She has already conquered the bunnies, she's doing a wonderful job protecting the tribe, so now she wants to get her paws in some of those pesky little fish. The water does look a little bit deep there, like maybe her nose isn't above the waves after all. Hopefully she'll be okay. So far, the only time I've noticed the creatures take drowning damage is if they're inside these waterfalls. So we'll just keep a close eye on her, just in case she struggles overnight. Now unfortunately, I believe Rameme is getting super, super old now. She's on her very last day. Oh no, so she's going to have to actually pass those bluebird feathers on to her son Ronuta to make sure that the dream continues on in him so he can keep traveling to different islands to try to find Adam's lost family. He only has 2 gems too, so he's still very young for this job, but it's clear that his family is going to be by him every step of the way. So let's give him at least one of the bluebird feathers. Maybe the reason why he's not flaunting that last one is because he's not sure if he's ready for the responsibility just yet. But his mother still trusts him with all of her heart, and will have her place down this very last nest so she can have her very last baby on the next turn too. Luckily, even though she's going to be leaving them behind, even though she won't get the chance to meet her last baby, she knows that they're going to be so well cared for, so well loved because Button is still here and all of their older brothers too. In fact, we'll settle them all down right in a circle around Rameme. We can pick up some of the grass as well to make sure that nothing dangerous is going to come out. Only little bunnies looking to steal some of those shriveled up berries. And we don't mind if they come up to see our new baby. That might actually be the last turn that we needed to make too. All of our creatures are all tired out for the day, so let's zoom in and watch as Rameme unfortunately passes away, though not without sharing all of the stories that she possibly can to Ronuta. And look at this little baby. Oh, she has the orange fur just like Adam did. She doesn't have the poison fangs, of course, but she does have the big nose, so that means she'll be able to help her brothers quite a bit as they explore this area. I'm so glad to see the stripes pull through again, though. So yet again, Takir has given us a lovely stripey baby, and I'm sure she's going to be just as well connected to Adam's family as her own brother Ronuta. But why don't you go ahead and grab this bunny for us so you have a little bit of extra meat to feed to your newest little sibling. We'll make sure that Issa's okay, of course. She looks perfectly fine. She didn't take any drowning damage overnight, so she should be safe there. And then last but not least, we have this baby back here in the jungle again. Oh my goodness, I think it's actually a male. Yeah, I see that big spiky mane on the top of his head. He looks almost just like Truffle. But of course, with his mother's ever lovely ram horns and spikes, all in that beautiful pink rosy color. So I think we'll actually name this baby Camo, which was a name that quite a few of you suggested for Truffle. And since he looks so much like him, I think it would be pretty fitting. And then of course we'll have to take a closer look at Lasila too. Oh, I love the stripes on her back. They look like little ripples almost. Little ripples in the waves. I wonder if that's because we're maybe going to meet our very first challenge island in the north. I'm pretty sure that this is going to lead us to that tiny chain of islands that we ended on our Harmony Island series. Fingers crossed anyway, so maybe it's some sort of sign. Maybe Takir gave her those very special stripes to give them a taste of what lies ahead. So perhaps as they turn their attentions to the next great migration, Lasila might feel a little more connected to the water than the rest of her tribe mates. And if we do find ourselves right in the middle of the ocean, then that will be particularly helpful. So hopefully in the next episode, when Ronuta grows, we can start bringing them up to those special ports. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys!